I'm Matthew Schinkel here with your Week 2 Friday Football Flashback. Tri-County South action between the West Green Pioneers and the Mapletown Maples. West Green entered the game 1-0 in the conference, while Mapletown was yet to face a conference team, however was 1-1 overall on the season. The first score of the game was on a 45-yard touchdown pass from quarterback Zach Pettit to Nathan Drudnick on their first drive of the game. The Pioneer two-point attempt was no good, making the score 6-0 after just one quarter of play. Move to the second quarter, and running back Dylan Rush from Mapletown punches it in from 3 yards up to tie the game up at 6. West Green responded quickly on their next drive. Pettit hit Drudnick again, this time for an 18-yard connection and the score. West Green on their next drive after that saw Pettit flash his speed rather than his arm, rushing for a 57-yard touchdown to go up 22-6 at halftime. Third quarter, Pettit fakes pitch and tosses to, guessed it, Drudnick for a 42-yard touchdown after he gets past the cornerback and safety to put West Green up by 22. That was the only score of the third quarter. Mapletown still fighting late in the game as Rush gets through the defense for his second touchdown of the game. He was rushed once more, this time on a broken pass play. Rush in this game became Mapletown's all-time leader in rushing yards and rushing touchdowns. And that same drive still alive during the fourth quarter. The Maples facing a 4th-and-5, but the Pioneer defense forces the turnover on downs. Later in the fourth quarter, Pettit would rush for a 60-yard touchdown. Blocked punt for a touchdown would bring the game to its final score of 42-12. DOR staff writer Luke Campbell got the chance to chat with Dylan Rush after the game.
Here with Dylan Rush. Dylan, you broke the school record for both yards and touchdowns tonight. Tell me a little bit about how it felt. Obviously, you didn't get the result that you wanted, but quite the award for you.
Well, I mean, it's great to finally get it over with, but of course we wanted the W with it, but we couldn't get it, but I'm just glad it's over with, so now we can really just focus on the team and not worrying about the records.
How much was that on your mind? I mean, whether it be the first game, second game, obviously you knew you were nearing that record. How good does it feel that it's kind of, like you mentioned, behind you, but you have other individual goals for yourself?
I mean, Derek Bonner was one heck of a player, and it's just great to be in the same category as him, and I'm just glad it's over with, and we can just focus on the team.
What was your thoughts kind of walking off the field, holding the ball, obviously? Coach gave you a hug. Tell me a little bit about that experience and just what it's meant to you. You're getting 30, 40 carries a night. So tell me a little bit about just how hard you've worked for this achievement and it's finally here.
Well, ever since I started football, my dad has been just coaching me and just wanting me to do the best that I can. And just all of us for the family.
Are there any more goals for this season? Tell me a little bit. Is there another milestone you'd like to hit?
Well, I mean, I'm not really focused on my goals. I just want to get the wins and make playoffs for the team.
Wonderful. Well, hey, thank you very much, Dylan. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.